Hey guys, Eric here from California Dry Fly, and back with another video. What we're going to do today is we're going to talk about my bow. Deer season opens in 28 days, so I've been focusing a lot on getting set up for that. I've got trail cameras set out on the property. I'm going to go back this week and check out. Hopefully we'll see some good bucks on there, and we'll know what we're doing opening day. Now, I believe I have to work opening day, so it's going to be opening evening for me, and then the following Sunday. Anyways, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about the bow I'm going to be shooting. I did have to switch bows. I was shooting the Hoyt Carbon Defiant Turbo. It was too aggressive and was giving me trouble with my wrist, so I had to switch bows. I sold that bow, took everything off of it, sold it as a bare bow, and got a new bow. What I did get was the Hoyt RX1 from Redworks. This is the... and so far has been an amazing bow. It is an all carbon bow. This bow is 32 inches axle to axle. I went with the Hoyt 8-inch stabilizer, which I added a few more weights to. I'm going to shoot it this evening and see how it turns out once the wind dies. I'm shooting a Fast Eddy single pin Spot Hog Hoyt Ultra Rest drop away, and the bow has been amazing. It's smoother. It's a little bit easier for me to shoot. I can shoot it longer. It's super light, super comfortable. Has a great wall and a great let off. So it's more comfortable for me to shoot, which is why I switched to this bow. Now, I also switched arrows when I switched to this bow. Now, I've been shooting gold tips as long as I can remember. I shoot the gold tip 340 Hunters. I shoot a 70-pound bow, which is what this is set up at. It's actually about 72 pounds. And I went with a 340 gold tip kinetic pierce, which is an amazing little arrow. They're a bit on the thin side diameter wise. This arrow here is, I took that off. I don't know what the exact inch per weight is on this one, but anyway, it has a very, very, heavy front section there with that jacket and the field point. I shoot 100 grain field points. I'm going to shoot 100 grain broadheads. Right now that arrow is sitting about 403 grams right now for the whole setup on the arrow, which is really good for my 70 pound and a 27.5 draw length. Arrows are shooting good. They're shooting wonderful. They're grouping tight. I'm having clean groups, and when I do go for a shot on one of my targets, it's always in the kill zone if I don't mess up. Now, as a release, I'm shooting the True Fire Hardcore release in a hook style. I don't know if you can see that, but it's a hook style release, which for me is a little bit nicer for hunting season because I can just kind of loop on it real quick and go. Anyways, guys, this is my new Hoyt bow. If you have any questions about it, shoot me a comment down below, and like I said, the ultimate goal this year is hopefully you guys will see me take a deer on video with this bow this year. That is my ultimate goal this year. Like I said, 27 days away, A zone opens, and we will be on them, I hope. You'll see, I got 28 days. You're going to see me doing some practicing with this. I might practice a little later if the wind dies down. You're going to see a little more reviews on it. If you guys have any questions about the sight I use, the drop away, the bow, any more specs, shoot me a comment, let me know. I'll get them on there and reply to you as quick as I can. Anyways, that's the bow I'm shooting. Those are the arrows I'm shooting. And I'm going to shoot all, I'm going to run the arrows the rest of the season into next season, and I'm going to shoot the bow probably for the next 5 years. I don't think that's going anywhere. If you guys have any questions, once again, I picked this setup up from my local shop, which is West Coast Archery. It's in Dixon, California. The guy's name is Chad. He's awesome. He's friendly, and he's very helpful. So if you guys have any questions or need a new bow, need an old bow set up, stop by and see him. You will not waste your time. And like I said, they do have an indoor range, which when it's windy, it's hot, it is nice. It's only 20 yards, but it's nice to go in there and get a few shots in, especially get warmed up maybe right before the season or something like that, and you really want to make sure you're dialed in with no climate issues. Head on down to the indoor range, give a few shots downrange. I pick up all my stuff from there. I buy all my products, all my arrows, everything I have for my bow is purchased from them. So, once again, guys, if you have any more questions, want any answer to anything, or want to see any of the gear I use in any of my other videos, or in this video, or anything you guys see behind me, if you guys want to know anything about it, drop me a comment. Once again, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification button, and I will see you guys on my next video.